in the present season. In the previous season, I had discussed one part of Syadvada, where I have shown how Jaina maintains that knowledge is always partial. It cannot be absolute. Now, this idea is called Syadvada. And this Syadvada is also presented in the form of Saptabhangi Naya. What is this? Jainism holds that this partial and relative knowledge can be presented, can be expressed in the form of seven statements, that is, in seven ways. And since the number is seven statements, that's why this is known as Saptabhangi Naya. Now, these are as follows. Number one, Syat Asti. Number two, Syat Nasti. Number three, Syat Asti Cha Nasti Cha. Sati Alaktabhyam. Sati Alaktabhyam. My age. Sati Asti Cha Alaktabhyam. Alaktabhyam Cha. Shat Nasti Cha Avaktavyam Cha. And seven, Shat Asti Cha Nasti Cha Avaktavyam Cha. These are seven statements. These are seven ways in which one can express the knowledge of certain thing. Sat asti, relatively a thing exists. Sat nasti, relatively a thing does not exist. Sat asti cha nasti cha, relatively a thing exists and relatively a thing does not exist. Then sat avaktavyam, relatively a thing is indescribable. And the rest three, 5, 6, 7 are the combinations of the between past four, second four, third four. So these are seven statements, judgments, which are called Naya. And each seven judgments are called Saptabhangi Naya. So, this is the entire theory of Syadvada advocated by Jaina. Now, there are certain comments which are given against this theory. Now, Vedanta philosophy and also some other philosophies, they have commented on this Syadvada or Saptabhangi Naya of Jaina. They argue that this sort of theory is nothing but a full of contradictions. Sat Asti, Sat Nasti. What is this? This is the way how they argue against Jainism. So it's not a worthy theory. It's not a theory which can be acceptable. But such comment made by critics does not seem to be correct. The reason is that Jainism is not telling that all these are from one point of view. Rather, Jainism is telling that from one point of view it exists, from another point of view it does not exist. So there is no question of its being contradictory. There is no contradiction in this. Now the second comment is given that why do we stop at 7? When Jainism is multiplying by making combinations between first and fourth, between second and fourth, between third and fourth, reaching to 7, then why not go ahead? We can go on combining, and getting more and more statements. So, it is argued that, in fact, basic statements are only 4, from first to fourth, and rest are just additions. So this is not a complete and adequate theory. Now the third comment is made against Syadvada that Jainism seems to be inconsistent in mentioning this theory of Syadvada. The reason is that here at this point Jainism said that knowledge is relative. There cannot be a complete and absolute knowledge. But when Jainism talks about the knowledge of the Tirthankaras, those who have attained Kaivalya, those who have attained liberation and moksha, Jainism say that they can have an absolute knowledge. They can have full knowledge. That is called Kaivalya. So, this sort of idea that Jainism is giving is not very consistent with its Syadvada theory, which strongly holds the view that knowledge is always partial and relative. However, comments are made agreed. But one thing is very clear, and that thing is that there is some point when Jainism says that knowledge is partial. Even today's science is also supporting this view. Science also says that we cannot claim to have full and complete knowledge of certain things. Our knowledge is always partial and relative. This is the reason that science does not claim knowledge to be certain and necessary, knowledge to be complete and full. So, what we find that long back Jainism talked about relative and partial knowledge is now being strongly supported by science. So we find that this theory of Syadvada had some profound footing. So it is in this session that I have discussed Syadvada of Jainism, and in the next session I shall be discussing the philosophy of Buddhism. Thank you.